Hello, I'm Kevin Anderson, the Science Education Consultant here at the Wisconsin Department of Public Instruction. As you've probably heard, we have new science standards for the state now, which we're very excited about. I decided to make a quick video about how those new Wisconsin standards for science compare with the next generation science standards, as there's been many questions about how those two things connect. With many of our districts, really over 80%, using the next gen to some extent, I thought it'd be important to share some insights on how the standards are similar and different, and some of the nice resources that we have within our Wisconsin Standards for Science. If you have any questions, please feel free to send me an email. I hope you find this video useful as you work to understand these new standards and improve science programs within your districts. Our Standards Committee settled upon this statement for a vision for Wisconsin science education. It comes from the Framework for K-12 Science put out by the National Academies. A big question to consider is, what is your vision for students in your school or district? Having a vision is an important first part in the improvement process. It's critical to know what you're aiming for and how you'll know when you get there. Before we dig into the Wisconsin Standards for Science, I'm going to briefly review the next generation science standards as we use these standards in the framework to develop our state standards. Additionally, with over 80% of Wisconsin schools using the NGSS to some extent, it makes sense to briefly consider how those are structured and used before going into how the Wisconsin Standards for Science are different. So you'll see that at the top of an NGSS standards page, there are a series of bold black statements, which are the performance expectations. There are also some clarification statements and assessment boundaries in red along with them. Notably, these performance expectations are not meant to prescribe instructional practice. They are examples of ways to bring the practices, content, and cross-cutting concepts together, but not the only way. Many schools have been using them to guide instruction, which wasn't their intended purpose. So for designing lessons and units, I'd look at those blue, orange, and green boxes, the three dimensions of the next-gen standards, and the three dimensions of our Wisconsin Standards for Science. I'd start by considering the disciplinary core ideas or the content in the orange box when I'm thinking about a lesson. And in particular, I want to determine which phenomena students might investigate that relate to the content. I'd then begin to consider how I'd want students to interact with, make sense of, and investigate this phenomenon in order to have them understand the content. So I'd strategically select practices in the blue boxes to build that understanding. Finally, I'd consider how I want students to be thinking about the content as they engage in the practices, using the cross-cutting concepts, which is the green box, to frame that thinking. On this page, it's also worth noting that at the bottom of the NGSS practice and the cross-cutting concepts boxes, you'll see some connections to the nature of science and connections to engineering, technology, and society ideas. Because our standards were based on the NGSS and that NRC framework, you can really use either set of standards. The DCIs, the practices, the cross-cutting concepts will be essentially the same. The NGSS does have a lot of resources that we don't, like the connections at the bottom of the page to ELA and mathematics. Also, the fact that on a standards page, just about everything there is a clickable link that takes you to more information on a topic or idea. Our Wisconsin standards, though, do have some unique and helpful elements, which I'll discuss further here. So here's an image of the NGSS next to a page of our Wisconsin science standards. Our state standards all have a consistent format that shows progressions of learning in grade bands K2, 3, 5, 6, 8, and 9, 12. Those progressions are useful tools in planning coherent and appropriate instruction and assessment for students. You'll see that our Wisconsin standards don't have all three dimensions on one page like the NGSS. This page of our standards on the right, which is orange, is a page detailing disciplinary core ideas or content. You'll also see separate pages that provide progressions of the practice standards, that'll be in blue, and the cross-cutting concept standards in green, keeping the coloration similar to those of the NGSS. Another difference in the Wisconsin standards is that those bold performance expectations are not at the top of the page as they are in the NGSS. We wanted to make it clear that those are sample connections across the three dimensions, so we noted those in a purple box below each orange disciplinary core idea section. In Wisconsin language, we also call those performance indicators as opposed to performance expectations. And while these are noted as examples, it's important to realize that these are used by the company creating our Ford exam in science in grades 4 and 8. They do consider these statements as models to draw from for creating sets of test items. We did make a few minor changes in the language of the NGSS performance expectations in putting them into our document. largely for clarity, such as removing things like and or and selecting either and or or. But the content, the practice, or the cross-cutting concept wasn't changed from the NGSS PEs to those performance indicator samples that we have. So another difference that you'll see in our Wisconsin Standards for Science, in the NGSS, all three dimensions are located on the same page, those three colored boxes, emphasizing they should all be used together to design instruction. Because we have separate pages for each dimension in our Wisconsin Standards, we wanted a way to emphasize the importance for connecting the three dimensions. And we landed on the phrase, students use science and engineering practices, cross-cutting concepts, and an understanding of disciplinary core ideas to make sense of phenomena and solve problems. You'll find that on the top of each standards page. And really, to become a performance indicator, the content from the individual boxes has to be placed into that phrase. So if you're looking at the practice of modeling, and you would say students develop and use models instead of just saying they use science and engineering practices. Or if you're studying heredity, you might say students use science and engineering practices, cross-cutting concepts, and an understanding that genetic variation can result from mutations to make sense of phenomena and solve problems. Another difference in our standards is that we didn't include every element of every disciplinary core idea. The content pieces we list are sometimes condensed versions of what's possible. They're largely pulled from Appendix E in the NGSS as a starting point, though we added to those as well. We didn't want to have huge lists of content, which would have made this document dozens of pages longer. Instead, this higher-level view of content provides districts more flexibility in relation to the content taught, while keeping the core content the same, and allowing districts and educators to go deeper based on your student interest and your community connections. When I was reviewing the NGSS page earlier, I noted that there are sometimes connections to the nature of science and engineering, technology, and society connections in those boxes of practices and cross-cutting concepts. So in the experience of the writing committee, those ideas often get overlooked. They're not really seen as practices or as cross-cutting concepts, kind of add-ons at the bottom of those sections. And so we decided to add another disciplinary core idea section to our standards that includes ideas from these areas and expands on them a little bit. So we have a third section to our Engineering, Technology, and Applications of Science section. This will be ETS3, and it's titled The Nature of Science and Engineering. This section includes an additional progression of understanding that should be part of instruction in science courses. The next gen, as you probably know, has several useful appendices to support educators, and we certainly suggest you keep using those. We've also begun creating appendices for our Wisconsin Standards for Science. The first that has been released is a series of Wisconsin-specific context connected to the content. While the ideas are connected to particular grade band statements, as you'll see, they can often be used at other grade levels as well. And in addition to these Wisconsin-specific connections, there are also engineering project ideas linked to the science content. With engineering being a new subject for many teachers, we felt it would be helpful to have lists of engineering topics connected to the science being taught, particularly as engineering is not meant to be taught as an isolated subject, but meant to extend and deepen students' scientific learning. Well, I hope you find the Wisconsin Standards for Science to be a useful tool to support your science instruction or science instruction throughout your district. Looking at these standards documents, I hope you consider what other resources might be useful and what other resources you've developed that might be useful for other districts. Please send me an email and share those tools. And as you consider science instruction in your classroom, school, district, and community, there's two questions I'd encourage you to continue to reflect on. We really started with these at the beginning as well, which is thinking, how is our work with science standards going to move us closer to our vision? And how will we know we're moving students closer to that vision? Let me know how I can help in this process. Cheers.